there, welcome on my channel. My name is Irene and welcome to this very special house build video, speed building video in The Sims 4. Today you can see one of my biggest projects yet. Today it's time, finally, for the second part of my $1 million mega mansion build. And yeah, normally I would recommend you to watch the first video first. I will put a link on your screen right now. Normally I really like the exterior part more, but this time, yeah, I would recommend you to just stick with this video if you haven't seen the first part already and maybe you want to watch it after this. But yeah, I'm just so proud of this part of the video. I'm so happy with it. As I was saying, in the first part, the whole exterior creation took place, and today we're on to the massive and extremely crazy interior of this house. And my plan was to first, summarize for you what you can expect in this video and in this interior. So yeah, let's go with that. At first, I wanted to tell you there will be secret corridors, secret doors, secret rooms. I thought that was the most exciting thing. So I thought, let's just start with that. I was so happy with that. I never worked in that way. And some strange things are happening in this house. But now the whole list, there will be 8 bedrooms. Because I thought you can only upload or put to 8 Sims in your game. So yeah, I really wanted to make 8 bedrooms. There are also 8 bathrooms, but they're not all attached to the bedrooms. Some of the bathrooms are with the pools or with the spa area or the basketball court, because there's actually a basketball court as well. Of course, the whole normal things for a mansion are here. As you can see, I'm working on the living room right now, but there will be a kitchen, of course, a very luxurious one though. And there will be a dining room and all the standard stuff. But there also will be a very big vault filled with gold of the very rich Sim that is living here. There will be 4 pools in this house, 2 outdoor pools, 2 indoor pools, and 1 of the pools. Yeah, I'm so happy with that. I've made a glass floor in the pool, and underneath that pool, there's the other pool. So when you're swimming in the upper pool, you can watch through the floor and you can see the pool that's underneath there. Yeah, it's a little bit bonkers, but there's a lot of bonkers in this house, actually. But yeah, there will be a spa, sauna area thing. There will be a fitness area, a gym. And yeah, attached to that, there will be a basketball court. I was just mentioning it. And yeah, I really wanted to build an end game house. And yeah, I also really wanted to take the opportunity to use a lot of objects and activities that I've never put in my builds before. So yeah, it was the perfect time to use the basketball court. It's actually from the City Living Pack, and yeah, you will see it later on. But there's a gym attached to it, and attached to that there are some showers, and yeah. So that's one of the bathrooms. There is an art studio, actually. Yeah, that's an area where your Sim can paint, and there are lots of expensive paintings, of course. There will be a cinema. You wouldn't want to miss a cinema in a house like that. There will be a library, and that's actually my favorite part of this build. It is 2 stories high. It has a very big wall, all filled with books, and yeah, very classic library. I'm so happy how that turned out. There will be an office. Dining room, kitchen, I already had that. There will be a music room with a piano, microphone, all the guitars just hanging on the wall, a lot of violins. There will be a very strange woohoo/wine room. Yeah, it's very strange, but yeah, it is there. And there will be a walk-in closet, and I think I've got everything now. Oh no, I almost forgot. There is a guest house as well. It's a small house with a bathroom, a living room, a bed. And yeah, I thought you can use it as a guest house, but you can use it as a house for a butler too. And yeah, I really think I've got everything now. And as you can see, I'm working on the library here. And yeah, I really wanted to build a very high library, as you can see here. It was a little bit difficult to take good screenshots of it. But yeah, I was really happy with it though. I used these bookcases from the Strangerville pack. I actually do not use the items from the Strangerville pack that much. I use some of the very cool doors and these bookcases. And yeah, I got a little bit of the Dark Souls libraries in my mind, or the Harry Potter libraries. So yeah, I went with that. And yeah, I think it's a very, some kind of cozy area, and with all the books. And yeah, I really love reading, and I just want to sit there with my book. And yeah, but yeah, another thing, as I was mentioning, there's an art studio here, there's a basketball court there, yeah, a lot of different things. So I thought this house would be very fitting for some typical Sims. So maybe you want to put a very wealthy celebrity that has a very amazing voice, or is very good on the guitar, or in this house, a very famous celebrity. That's possible because there are a lot of instruments, so it would be very fitting for a Sim like that. But because there's an art studio too, it would be very fitting for a very rich painter. And yeah, there's a basketball court, so maybe you want to put a very famous athlete in a house like this. And yeah, you can go all kinds of ways in this house. So yeah, I was very happy with that too. And I actually thought it would be a little bit of a problem to reach the 100, not the 100 million, that would be really bonkers, to reach the million simoleon points. So I gave the Sim in this house exactly a million simoleons. I done that at the beginning of the previous video, at the beginning when I was building the exterior of this house. And yeah, as you can see, there's still 469,000 left. And I thought, oh, maybe it's going to be a little bit difficult to reach the bottom of that. And no, it weren't. I actually have to give myself more money. And eventually the house is at a price of 1.2 million simoleons. So yeah, I thought it would be a little bit more difficult, especially because I didn't want to go with all marble floors and marble walls and marble stuff and just all the gold. And yeah, we have a lot of very crazy and very luxurious items in the Get Famous pack. And yeah, that would be the obvious choice. But I still wanted to give this house a rock and roll feel. So I wanted to use a lot of woods, a lot of reds, a lot of guitars. There are some crazy frames on the walls with guitars in them. And yeah, I wanted to keep it a little bit in that vibe. And you can see it in the room where I'm working on right now too. This is the bar. And yeah, maybe you've noticed it already, there will be a lot of cuts in this video, because yeah, it took me so much time to build this. And yeah, that's why I already put all the wallpaper in every single room. I already put all the flooring in. In some rooms I already put the curtains in. Because yeah, I really wanted to come up with plans and ideas to make this video as short as I can. And yeah, at the end it came out at, I think, around 30, maybe 40. I'm not sure, I cannot see it right now. But yeah, I thought when I just left all the whole process, in with the picking of the the wallpapers and everything, it would be way too long. And yeah, sometimes you can see me cut in the video because I really wanted to work on one area, then stop recording, then go to the next area, prepare the whole area for the recording, and then start recording again. So you can see a lot of different cuts of of me building this house. So yeah, maybe it's a little bit annoying, but I think it will be okay though. But yeah, the nightclub, as you can see, there are some very cool paintings on the wall. I think, yeah, are there paintings? Or no, they're definitely not pictures, but well, they're very big things on the wall, wall decorations. They are from the Vintage Glamour pack, and I actually use that art style, or that art, a lot in the house. I use it in several rooms. I thought the idea in my mind, was maybe a very wealthy, very pretty woman is living here. And yes, she has a very old drawings of herself in the house, maybe like Marilyn Monroe kind of, yeah, style. So yeah, I went with that. And I thought it was just, yeah, the most pretty with the brown wood and with the reds and yeah, some of the other paintings. Some are very classic and yeah, I wasn't that happy with them. So I've used these paintings a couple of times, but I did use some other very cool, yeah, cinema-like posters with different, yeah, movies on them. They are from the Get Famous pack though. But yeah, let's go to this part of this video because I was so happy with this plan. As you can see, here is the pool that I was talking about with the glass floor and with a pool underneath it. And yeah, it's just it's just bonkers to think that you could have something like that. But yeah, I really wanted to do something like it. At first, I wanted to make just a room under it. It would be crazy as well, I thought. So you can sit there, maybe a nightclub, and you can watch up and you can see the Sims swimming, yeah, above you. But I thought it was maybe a little bit more crazy to put another pool under it. So yeah, I went with that and you can see the end result over here. But I also already built the basketball court. And yeah, as you can see, I started with the living room and now I'm onto, yeah, these things. I thought maybe because this video was going to be long, maybe some people are getting bored with it, I don't know, but maybe some people want to click away at a certain point. So I thought, let's do the interesting things. Yeah, at the beginning or at the middle, I think a lot of the rooms in this house are very interesting, but I've kept the bedrooms and the bathrooms because there are a lot of them just at the end of the video. Because yeah, I thought there's so many cool and strange rooms in this house and I really wanted to show them off. So before some people are clicking away, I thought, yeah, well, let's just show the very cool stuff off. Yeah, at the beginning of this video, I've used these waterfalls, yeah, to make a very cool feel in the corridor. And yeah, here's the basketball area, basketball court. And these posters I was talking about, they are, yeah, the very movie things. Later on, I will put a gym over there as well with a bathroom, but at this point my plan was to put the gym in one of the buildings that are, yeah, above ground. But yeah, one of these buildings that I wanted to use for it turned out to be very fitting for the butler room, so I changed it up in that. And yeah, I wanted to place some couches here for your Sims to, yeah, where they can hang and watch other Sims play basketball. I actually never really played basketball in the game, so yeah, it made me so curious how it would work. Can you actually make teams with your Sims and yeah, play basketball just against each other? I'm not sure, I'm so curious. I actually really want to check this out right now, but yeah, maybe I will do that later on. But I'm on to the office right now, and in this office I will create two secret doors later, and one will be leading to the vault and one will be leading to the very strange woohoo slash wine room. It will be upstairs from here. But yeah, I thought an office for a very rich Sim, yeah, would be appropriate. I thought it was the best way to incorporate a desk in this house with a computer. And yeah, as I was mentioning, it would be maybe a little bit obvious to go with marble floors and marble walls because the whole exterior of the house is very white as well. But yeah, I really wanted to go with this style. Very, very classic, very modern. I actually had Wayne Manor in the back of my mind with the interior. The exterior of this house looks totally different than Wayne Manor. And I actually mean Wayne Manor in the TV show Gotham. There are of course several Wayne Manors out there in the DC universe, but yeah, I've got the Gotham one in the back of my mind, and it has a very, yeah, wooden walls too, and yeah, a lot of red tones. So yeah, I had that in the back of my mind during, yeah, making the decisions in the interior. And because I had, yeah, unlimited money and I really wanted to use a lot of money, it was a very cool process because I really wanted to use very expensive items. There's a classic typewriter over here. As you can see, I'm already placing some expensive things in the area where the vault will be later on. And yeah, the glow bar, as you can see right now, yeah, over there, the white one. It's so cool. I never saw it before. It's, I think, from the vintage glamour pack. And yeah, it's perfect for this build, don't you think? But yeah, I never used it in one of my previous builds. I really like to build modern houses. I've done a lot in Solani as well, of course. But I think, yeah, this the thing wasn't really fitting. The bar, the glow bar, wasn't really fitting for the builds I've done so far. But yeah, for this one, I think it's just great. But well, we're going to the hoo-hoo room. Yeah, it's so strange. I don't know how I came up with this. I think it was a very late at night when I was building this. I actually built this during the night because normally I have to work during the day and yeah. But yeah, in some kind of way, I had to think about what to do with this room. And yeah, I really wanted to make a very big bed, but I didn't want to put really a bed in. So I used these ottomans and I've placed this thing above it. This is actually from the Island Living pack. And it's so strange that I could use Island Living items in a very big mansion like this. But I thought it, yeah, created a very cozy space. So yeah, that's why I've placed it there. And yeah, I've placed a bar over there too. As you can see, I've placed it around with the front of the bar to the walls. I thought, yeah, maybe it was a fitting for a room like this. I thought, yeah, it had to take a little bit too much space when I wanted to put the bar in, and yeah, in a more conventional way. And yeah, you can see another of the pretty woman pictures on the wall over here too. And yeah, the vault. Oh yay, I was so happy with this part. I really, yeah, I never saw a vault like this in real life before. I actually never saw a house like this in real life before. So I really had to dig in my imagination, but yeah, now we have these vault doors. And actually I wanted to put a pile of money in this vault, but you actually don't have a pile of money or just money in the game. An object that looks like money. If we have, please let me know, but I couldn't find it. I went through all the debug items too and I really couldn't find it. But the thing that I did find were gold bars. And yeah, I just went with them. I put a lot of them. It's on a very big pile. And yeah, on one of the tables later on, I was just figuring it out right here. As you can see, at first I just wanted to, yeah, create a whole pile just onto each other. But yeah, I will do, yeah, over here I placed this thing in. It is from the Get Famous pack. And yeah, just a lot of gold surrounding it. And as you can see, there's a secret door right there. And that secret door is actually leading with a very small corridor with another secret door to one of the two indoor pools. The one actually that has the glass ceiling with another pool above it. So yeah, it is a little bit strange because you have a very big vault door, yeah, at the front of it. But I thought it was very cool to have a, yeah, secret passage to enter the vault too. I don't know if there are still burglars in the game. Maybe it was going to be a little bit easy to, yeah, to go into this vault. But maybe, are there burglars in The Sims 4 right now, or were they just in the previous Sims games? I'm not sure, let me know. I think there aren't burglars in this part anymore. But well, if there are, please let me know. But yeah, I was very happy with how the vault turned out and with the screenshots of it as well. And someone was actually asking me last week if I could make the house tour at the end a little bit longer, a little bit more screenshots in it. And yeah, I actually took a lot of screenshots of this house. So the end part will be a little bit longer. I think maybe I could even make it longer than it is right now. But I really have to, yeah, work on it. So I promise you I will be working on it, and it will be a little bit longer in the future. But yeah, here's the music room. And yeah, at this point I still had 245,000 simoleons left. And yeah, I already knew over here that I could reach the million simoleon point very, very easy, but I still wanted to go further with it, so I placed some of the very expensive violins in. I think they are the most expensive items in the game. I say that very cautious. I'm not sure, but yeah, there are 15,000 simoleons and I put one in. As you can see, I put a lot of guitars on the wall. I've done that in my industrial builds as well. That was here a week ago, and I talk about this house over there as well. And yeah, I think it's just cool. I think that your Sims cannot pick a guitar off the wall in that way. So if you want to have your Sim over here that's playing really on a guitar, you have to place another guitar in. And here is the art studio. Yeah, I wanted to make a museum, an art studio, because I had these careers in the back of my mind, the type of Sims that could live here, and yeah, I thought it was very fitting for a very rich and very rich painter as well. So yeah, that's why I wanted to put an easel in, an art studio in. I've used these objects, as you can see, the wall things, all the stacked canvases. There's actually another item that is called stacked canvases. I don't know what's the name of this one, but it's actually a prop from the Get Famous pack. And yeah, I think it gives the whole art studio a little bit more the feel of an art studio. Maybe you thought it would be more fitting to have our studio at the back of this build, but I thought it would be cool to have your easel here with the amazing views at the front of the house, at the front yard. But I've put a table in it as well, a table from the Vintage Glamour Pack, and I put a fruit bowl on there as well. So if you want your Sim to paint a fruit bowl, it's very easy because it's in front of the easel. So yeah, I made that choice, and I still wanted to have, yeah, an area in the living room too where you can sit. And yeah, there are actually just a lot of different areas in this house where you can lounge, but in the living room there is a sunken area. I've made it at the very beginning of this video. I removed the foundation, and in that way, yeah, your Sims can sit in a sunken area in the living room. I know it's a little bit 70s, but I thought it was a little bit rock and roll as well, so that's why I went with it. And here is one of the indoor pools. It's actually the smallest one, or actually there's a very small pool too that should count as the fifth pool, but it's so small and has very big lights above it, so I thought it's more a water feature than a pool. But yeah, here there's a jacuzzi, and at first I wanted to put the sauna in here as well. But yeah, I already made the exterior. I made some choices in the placement of the windows. Of course, in building the whole interior, some of the windows I actually removed or replaced. But yeah, the area where I'm in right now, the windows were all on the perfect spot, and I didn't want to remove any of them. And I knew I still had a very big space at the first floor, or the second floor, I'm not sure, but I still had a very big space for a bathroom, and I knew a sauna would fit in over there. So here there's just a pool and a jacuzzi. And yeah, I've used the black marble walls over there. I wanted to use them in one of the rooms. I think, yeah, it's so kitsch. And they're actually a little bit ugly, I think. But I wanted to use them. And as I am saying for the third time right now, maybe it would be more obvious to use the marble walls in the entire build. But I just thought it was so, yeah, so kitsch. And yeah, a little bit ugly. So no, I just went with the black walls in that room. And now I'm on to the kitchen. I had a very big space in the kitchen. So yeah, I will cut a little bit in the video later on. I hope it's okay with all the cuts that I made in a recording. When I'm watching this back right now while recording this voiceover, I think it isn't that annoying. I hope you think so too. but well, the kitchen. Yeah, I wanted to make it very big, and then I still had a very big space left for a dining table. So I wanted to do something different with the dining table too. So I made a sunken room here, or a sunken room here as well. Just talked about it, that there's an area like this in the living room too. And yeah, as you can see, you just could saw me doing it. It's a very big, very strange sentence. I'm sorry. But you could just saw how I make the not the floor, yeah, how I make the floor lower over there. Oh, I'm sorry. It was so strange. But well, you could see how I've done that. I just built a room in it. I removed the floor in that room. After that, I removed all the walls. I deleted all the walls. And then I made put some floor tiles at the ground. And I made a stair into it. And in that way, you can build a sunken area in your rooms. And I thought, yeah, it gave it a little bit more. I think this area with the dining room, yeah, it's a little bit, it's so wide. But yeah, everything in this house is so extreme. So well, I thought it was okay. There is actually a very small bathroom over there too, and I actually cut some parts out of the video. I cut parts out of it, as I was mentioning earlier, when I placed in all the wallpapers and all the floors and some of the lights. And but I also cut a lot in this area, in this wing of the house, because yeah, there are a lot of bedrooms over here, 8 of them. I still kept the part in where I'm making the master bedroom and yeah, some part of the bathroom. As you can see, I'm onto 16,000 simoleons right now, so I've almost used up the entire $1 million where I started with, and I still had to furnish all the bedrooms and all the bathrooms. So I gave myself another 250 simoleons, as you can see right here. And this is actually the bathroom where the sauna is too. As you can see, I had a lot of space left over there. But yeah, I was talking about what I cut out of the video. I did as you can see right now, over here, I'm building the master bedroom. But yeah, all the other bedrooms, they're practically the same. In the kind of way, with the color choices that I've made and some of the beddings. And yeah, because there are actually a lot of them. So I think you can see a very small part of one of the bedrooms, except this one. But yeah, the other things I cut out, because yeah, as I was saying, I didn't want to make this video way too long, and I really wanted to keep all the very interesting things in it. And I think, yeah, you can see how I do bedrooms and bathrooms in all of my other builds. So yeah, that's why I cut it out. But I'm actually very happy with this master bedroom. It's so wide, it's so classic, and because it's so wide, I've got a little bit of a French feel with it, like a French room. And especially when I've placed these just the single red chair in it, yeah, I just was very happy with it. And yeah, maybe you've noticed it already, and it's going to be the same over here too. I placed a lot of these mirrors in. I thought, yeah, it was fitting to have a lot of mirrors in this house, because yeah, it's a very big mansion, it's very luxurious, and in my mind, in houses like that, there are a lot of mirrors. So I don't know if that's true, but in my mind it was true. So I used a lot of mirrors, and these ones are so cool. They are from the Vintage Glamour Pack, and yeah, you can, there are for the different room heights. So there's a short one, a medium one, and a tall one, and there are several different swatches for them. And yeah, I use them a lot in this build. And we're on to the hall. Oh no, I just cut it. Yeah, it was a very, I promise you, when I cut in the video, it's just repetitive parts. And as I was saying, with the bedrooms and the bathrooms and the hallway, I made a choice to make it very wide with some black, with a very big decorative ship on a table, and with a very big statue of a ballet dancer. And yeah, so I've done that, but you can see it in the screenshots though. But I'm on to, I think, almost the last part of this house. We're almost at the end. And at this part, I knew I was almost at the end of this very, very long process. And as I was saying, it is, I think, one of my biggest projects yet. But yeah, I am very happy with it though. It's a little bit strange to... I've said it before, but it's a little bit strange to talk about your own bills and are very happy with them or something like that. But yeah, I'm very proud of this. But yeah, you just could see me working on the space for the butler. It's like his own home, his own house with his own bathroom, his own living room, his own television. And that's actually a thing. There aren't that much televisions in this room. In this whole build, there is one in the dining room, and yeah, there is of course a very big cinema, as you can see right here. I'm working on it right now. You can see that everything is just attached to each other, but you can, because you can see the vault over there too, and the vault is actually underneath a different building. So yeah, I was very happy with how everything just came together and that everything was just attached to each other, and in that way, yeah, I could really make secret doors and secret rooms. And there are actually a little bit more secret doors that I did not talk about in this video yet. But maybe you want to download this house and put it in your game, and then you can find the other secret doors. Yeah, we're onto the screenshots right now. As I was saying, if you want to put this in your game, you can download it. It is on the gallery, but it's massive, as you can see. I actually thought my game was just broken a couple of times during building this, or especially during saving this. I really recommend you, if you're putting this in your game, to do it during the daylight, because there are a lot of lights in this build. And I really noticed when I was saving this build during the night, it took so much time. I think around 10 minutes. And sometimes I really thought my game was just broken. I just had a freeze screen. But then, yeah, I just done something else, and then I came back to the screen and the game was still working. So if you're having some troubles with putting it in your game and you think it takes so long to put it in, maybe you want to wait a little bit and it will work out, because my computer is actually a very crappy laptop. So when it works on this, on my crappy laptop, I think it will work on a lot of other PCs as well. Or actually crappy laptop, I'm very happy with my laptop because it runs this game. But yeah, I think when I can load this house in, you can do it as well. But yeah, I really hope you've enjoyed this video and you've enjoyed this part. And if you do, please give it a like or a comment or something. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. I would really, really appreciate it. I upload 3 times a week. I really try to build different things. I really like to push myself in the game. I really like to build different styles. So yeah, if that's something for you, or if you want to gather some inspiration for your builds, yeah, please subscribe. I hope to talk to you in one of my next videos, or maybe you want to watch the first part of this house. And yeah, I hope to talk to you soon. Have a great day and goodbye.